Hey, Kevin, what are you looking at?
Well, this is kind of how my brain works. No, this is a sculpture called Low Orbit. It is part of my Gordian Accordian series. The first one I did was called Sprung, and it actually had two of these, one inside the other. When I had it in a show, I actually had two different families fighting over it to see who was going to get to take it home. And the whole thinking behind this style of sculpture, I was just looking to see how far I could push the metal. I wanted to see the flow. I wanted to see what would happen as I bent it from one angle to the other. And can I actually make it come all the way back around on top of itself and make it meet up again? Another one I did in this series is called CounterSink. And it's a really, really fun little piece simply because when you look at it, you can't find where it began. You know, where did I start? Where did I end? The way everything just seamlessly came back together, the way the seam in here that's not cut finally meets back up with itself, and God, they're fun to play with. The biggest one of this series that I've done is called Square Up, and it's over 6 feet tall. And if you give it a little push, it kind of thinks it's Chubby Checker. It gets this little twist going on, gets this little wiggle, kind of like that. And the heaviest one I've done in this series is called Mondo. And it's 5 inches on a side, and it's pushing probably 5.5 feet by about 5 feet. It's a big monster. But boy, what a lot of fun I had just trying to piece all that together and weld it and shape it and move it all at the same time. And then, oh yeah, you got to pick it up and move it when you're done with it too. Probably the most difficult one I've done of this series is called Dorothy's Nightmare, where instead of like this, where it's a never-ending series and it just comes back around and feeds back into itself, Dorothy's Nightmare actually has a beginning and an end, but it begins and ends inside of itself. It comes off the table, it swirls around, and goes right back over the top of itself and comes right back down inside of it again. I'd love to even do a bigger one than Mondo, you know, in this Gordian Accordian series, but it would have to be built in an entirely different fashion. But I want to make one that's big enough that you could actually walk through it. Big enough where you could have it up over your head and see what's going on inside of it. I think that would be a whole lot of fun to create. So that's just a quick look at my Gordian Accordian series. You've seen a few pictures here of the other pieces. If you'd like to see the rest of them, pop out to my website. You'll find them out there. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button for me, and I'll see you next time. I'm getting dizzy just looking at it.